The onslaught of COVID-19 demanded a coordinated medical response unlike anything we've seen before. But how do you plan for a pandemic?
We didn't know what target we needed to meet.
Your usual and existing patient populations, what's going to happen to them?
How many patients?
How are we going to staff the critical care units to really, how are we going to staff the hospital?
How many ventilators? How many dialysis machines?
We have to think about safety in addition to deployment.
We knew from the get-go that no matter how this played out, that we were going to get stretched really thin.
Seeking support for medical staff treating COVID-19 patients, a call was sent out for volunteers.
When we call for reinforcements and help and ask our colleagues to step out of their comfort zone and come and stand with us in the ICU, the response was actually quite overwhelming.
From that, we got back nearly 800 volunteers. And these are everybody, urology, neurology, pediatrics, you name it.
You know, so I'm a surgical oncologist. I take care of patients with GI cancer and melanoma. So I think helping patients, helping my colleagues, and helping society as a whole is why I became a physician. And this once-in-a-lifetime crisis is something I identified as something where I'm able to do all three things and volunteer and help.
But securing volunteers was only half the battle.
On the one hand, what you're doing is you're trying to keep staffing low. On the other hand, what you want to do is have a plan in place to have adequate staffing when lots of patients come in. If we can keep staff away when the volume is low and do so in a way that, first of all, keeps them safe, prevents them from getting infections, then they're also available physically, emotionally, mentally, when we need them in the days and weeks to come. And that's the strategy that we used.
Basically, it's a lot of planning by a lot of people and then flexibility on the part of the volunteers that initially we were calling people as we need them, and then as it became clear we needed them consistently, it became a schedule.
The first day in the MICU, I was a bit nervous, but you know what? Very soon that anxiety was alleviated with comfort. And the reason for that is this is a whole team of individuals, of healthcare workers that are coming together and helping out society and helping out patients. So we were all in this together, and it was a very special thing to see.
I don't think we've really thought of ourselves as neurointensive care teams or surgeons or dermatologists. We've really thought of ourselves as Yale.
You know, what we really can't solve as an individual, we've been able to achieve as a community.
In these times of stress, what you see is that people's mission comes to the front. That this is why I went into medicine. This is why I became a nurse. This is why I work at Yale School of Medicine or Yale New Haven Hospital, is that I actually want to help. We're all in this together. And I think you just have to walk on the wards and see that that is life right now.